everybody. Welcome back to another episode here on a fine Tuesday, a quick tips with WeVideo. As always, I am Ryan, one of your hosts, and joining me again, as always, is Stu. Hey, Stu.
Hey, Ryan. How you doing?
Good, man. How are you?
I'm doing well.
I like the background you got rocking today. It's like really in preparation for the fall season coming into effect, right? So we've crossed over the into fall officially a couple of days ago, and your background is really screaming, I'm ready for fall.
Thank you. I am ready for fall. We've got some leaves changing colors out here. It's really, really beautiful. So yeah, love this time of the year.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like the cabin vibes are going strong.
They're strong. They're strong. Yeah, this is my music room. I've got the piano in here. Oh. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Fun room. Yeah.
Is that your the room that gives you creative inspiration as well? Could you say that?
You know, oftentimes just taking a walk gives me creative inspiration, to be honest.
Yeah, and for those of you who don't know, Stu lives in a fabulously natural space in the world. That I'm sure those walks provide incredible inspiration for you.
That's pretty spectacular, yeah.
Yeah,
lots of beautiful mountains, yeah.
Lots of beautiful mountains, yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, it is of just turned fall, and we're going to be preparing soon to be in the month of October. Believe it or not, this year is just flying by. And so in today's episode, we thought we would take advantage of something that is happening in October, not Halloween. We do have special Halloween episodes planned for all of you who enjoy the spooky season. But this episode is going to talk a little bit about an activity we have in our assignment ideas library, because it October, in addition to being spooky month, is also a world animal aware. Say it for me, Stu, because you have it. You had this.
It's World Animal Month coming up October.
World Animal Month. Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Uh huh. And so yeah, it's a time to celebrate animals and in their biodiversity and conservation and protection of animals, and just a great time for students to learn about animals.
Yeah, for sure. And within the month of October, there are many different days that celebrate specific aspects of animals around the world, and both domesticated and wild. So we thought it would be fun to show you one of our assignment ideas called Amazing Animals, for you to bring into your classroom with your students to, you know, capitalize on a fun and creative alternative possibly to your traditional animal report or some activity you may have done previously, not leveraging video. You can quickly and easily turn any essay or documentary project into a video project.
Yeah, I think, just to kind of hit that point home. Yeah, any sort of classic traditional report can easily be turned into a video project. And, you know, you're having students do research, you're having students compile information, and then, you know, outline and write a paper that's, presenting a coherent narrative. And so you can easily turn that into a video and then pair images and video clips and, you know, audio and voice recording and text to make it a multimodal, really dynamic, form of presenting that information. And then you can host a film festival. You can share those films more broadly outside of the class. And it just becomes a really authentic 21st century learning experience for students.
Yeah, absolutely. And through that, we're going to show you some specific editing features. Stu is going to show you how to create a soundscape utilizing our audio tools. And also we're going to touch on the chroma key feature, which is essentially keying out color from an image and playing around with some green screen images from our stock media library to kind of show you how he's created that multimodal experience so that you can quickly and easily bring this back and implement this into your classroom.
Awesome.
Yeah, so let's dive in.
Cool.
Amazing animals.
All righty, let's do this.
And as Stu's getting his screen shared, if you want to follow along with Stu, Join us inside of WeVideo, log in, and you know, get your editing fingers ready so you can in real time along with Stu start thinking about how you might create your own example to share with students.
Awesome. Yeah. So here I'm logged in WeVideo in a teacher account. And so to access this assignment, you can just go to the assignment ideas library. It's full of media projects and activities, including this one, the Amazing Animals Project, which is ready for you to assign to your class. So this one's going to come with an example video, instructions for students, as well as slides that are going to walk students through the process of sort of preparing to edit their video and then completing their video. So this is just kind of quickly what these slides look like. It'll present students with the project description, an example video that they can analyze for strengths and areas of improvement, a sample rubric that you know you can use as is or modify, and then some resources to research their animal, and then some graphic organizers to take notes and then write their script. A storyboard template where they can turn their script into a storyboard and start to plan like the images and the video clips and the audio they want to include in their video. And then a tutorial video, short tutorial video showing them how to edit in WeVideo. And then finally, once they're done and they've turned in their work, you can have your film fest together. So so everything you need is there. And this one also comes with a media bin and a starting block. And so I'll just open that up to show you. Essentially, a starting block is a template on the timeline that students can use to edit a little bit more quickly or use as a scaffold to help kind of structure their video there so they're not starting from a blank slate. And then you'll see already some media in the project bin as well. That's mostly the media that's used on this timeline.
You know, something else that's really cool about that is even if you don't want to provide that, it can be a really great share with students to see how the project was made itself. Like maybe you're not going to utilize that to have students replace media or have them use that to even get started if you want to use a blank timeline. But it can often be helpful to preview that with students to show them an idea of how the tracks layer together. So to at least give them and yourself kind of an idea about how Stu approached this work. Stu is the architect for many of these starting blocks. And so it's a really great way to kind of analyze or review the project before you get started, because you can see how he used multiple tracks, how he layered things, how the chroma key feature is going to work, and how all that plays together. So even if you don't use the starting block, it's a really cool place to begin analyzing how a piece of media comes together in the editor.
Absolutely. That's a great point. So I'm going to go ahead and save this as a draft to my class. We'll go with the science class for this one. And then there's this little pop up here. You can just use that to jump directly over to your science project. Looks like I double clicked on that and saved it twice. So I'll just delete one of those. So I can now just assign this quickly as is, just by clicking assign, or I can make some edits to this assignment. And so Ryan was sort of speaking to the starting block here. You can remove that if you want all students to just start with a blank timeline. You can also go in and modify it. So you can change this up if you want to make some tweaks to it as well. But I'm just going to leave it as is so I can show you what it's like to edit with the starting block that's in there.
Yep.
So that assignment has been assigned. I'm going to jump over to a student account. And I'm going to just open classes and open my science class. I see this Amazing Animals project. I'll go ahead and jump in. And that's going to pop me into the editor. So those instructions that we were looking at from the teacher side, those can be accessed by clicking the clipboard icon up here in the top right. And then students can access a link to the slides there. That's going to create a forced copy so that they can, edit their own slide deck, add their notes, their research notes and all that, build out their storyboard. And then there's a sample video here of a mini documentary, 2-minute video about sloths. So they can check that out as like an example of what they might create.
I love that video, by the way.
That's a fun one.
It's a great video to watch. Please watch it. I think, didn't you have something on our YouTube channel as well?
That video is there
too. It is that. Okay.
Yeah.
Go look for that after you're done watching us today. check out that amazing animals video. It is really well done.
Yeah, sloths are incredible. I don't know if you know that they have a symbiotic relationship with a type of moth that is only found on their fur. That's the only place that it lives in the world, is on the fur of a sloth.
I did not know that, and that is a fantastic fact for today.
If you watch, viewers, if you check out the example video, it gets a little bit into that, so you can learn a little bit about that. So we've got this template here, and just like the basics of using this template, you know, let's say you're going to make your video about lions or elephants, let's say. So I would just go to the stock media library, search for elephants and video clips about elephants. And then to bring that down to the editor, all I would do is click and drag over a video clip here and then click replace. And you'll notice that the media clip gets trimmed down and replaces the old media clip that was there. And then we've got this this text block here that's prompting students what kind of information to include. I guess I should say, what do they eat? I'll have to edit that. But where do they live? What do they eat? Are they herbivores, omnivores, or carnivores? So we could just come in here and say elephants are herbivores that I believe primarily eat grass.
Yep. Or the leaves, they strip the leaves of trees.
That's right.
Okay. With those wonderful trunks.
Yes. So elephants are incredible too. Yeah. Let's not get started on that, because there's so much we could say about that.
I could go down a rabbit hole about elephants.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we'll refrain from that.
Yeah. But yeah, so the scaffold's there, super easy to just go and replace the media, edit the text. And then, you know, also once you've sort of done that, you've kind of got your script right in front of you. So for example, I would finish doing that, right? Finish replacing the media and editing the text. And then I would drag the playhead to the beginning of my, my video and come to the project bin and click narrate to add a voice recording. And let's get that going. Here we go.
Yeah, always make sure you have access to your microphone.
Yeah. and so what we're going to see is with the clip that I edited, the text is right in front of me when this changes. So I could just read that, right? Elephants are herbivores that primarily eat grass and leaves of trees. And then I could continue to read my script as the media changes.
What I love about that is you're building a script inside of the video itself rather than having something external, which is fine too if you're writing a script outside of the product, but this sort of template provides you the ability to record your voice directly from the media that you've put on screen already.
Totally. Yeah, yeah. Super easy. It's right in front of you. And so that voice recording's down here. I'm going to just delete this for now, but that's how you could add the voice recording to this project. And then a couple other things we wanted to talk about. One was using the chroma key tool. So that's how I sort of built this title screen here. Let's see. I'm going to search videos.
And just so you know, this is all content that Stu's finding in our stock media library. But if you have media from other sources that you're able to use, you can always upload that media and use that in your project as well.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm just searching in the stock media library, green screen elephant, and there's a lot in here, right? Yeah. And so let's use this one. I'll click and drag it down over the clip that's there, click replace. And then to remove the green screen, I'm just going to double click on this green screen clip, click key in to access the chroma key tool, select the color picker, and then select the color that I want to remove. And then I can see there's some green edges here. And so I'm just going to use this defringe tool to kind of make adjustments. If you want, you can click show mask, and that's going to reveal the transparent and opaque parts of your image in black and white. So we can see the opaque part where we still see the elephant is white. the transparent part where the color has been removed is black. And that can be helpful sometimes for just spotting some places where the color hasn't been removed, or a color you wanted to keep has been removed, and then you can use the defringe sliders that way.
Nice.
So yeah. And I might even like come in here and use the transform tool on this one and flip this image and then click and drag it, maybe adjust the size a little bit so we have some room for our text, and then the animal's facing our text. And then, and then I would just come in here, edit the text here. You can, you know, change the color. I'd probably do a different font on this one. It looks a little bit better.
Nice. I like that. It pops.
Yeah. And then we've got this background image. So, you know, we could look for some different media to include as our background. Maybe something like this. Let's just see.
And again, he's just replacing the media. It's going to trim it for him already. Yeah, nice.
Yeah, so here we go.
Oh, that's epic. That's so good.
Yeah. And then, you know, you could replace the audio as well. What's a good genre of music that we should search for here?
Oh gosh. I don't know. Like that clip was fine, but I was thinking like maybe some like drum and bass or something.
Drum and bass. Let's check it out. Oh, I love that already.
Yes, that's perfect. I don't know why. It's like elephants, like how big they are. It feels bassy to me, you know, like they've got like, they step on the earth and it can create those low frequency tones.
I could see that. Let's check this out.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah. So there you have it. So that's using the chroma key tool and just kind of building out your title screen, you know, a fun intro to your video. It's sort of where you get your creativity gets to thrive and you get to create something fun. So, and then the other thing we want to talk about was sort of building a soundscape for your video. So I'm going to just delete what's here. Give us kind of a fresh start. And we're going to go to the stock media library and we're going to search for some sound effects. So let's go with rainforest, Okay, let me try a different search term real quick. Here we go.
Did you hear birds?
Yeah, this one's. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that one's pretty good. Nice. So I'm going to drag that down. And we can actually use what's called a J cut on this one, where you introduce the sound before you actually. You introduce the sound of a scene before you actually visually see the scene. Mm-hmm. It's called a J cut because if we look at this clip that the sound would be coming from, it sort of makes a J with the audio. Right. Clip below it, that kind of shape. And then this is a tool I love to use. It's this show audio levels tool. And so we see now when I click that, so I clicked audio and opacity and clicked show audio level, this blue line appears that represents the volume of our clip. And so right now it's at 100%, but we could kind of like fade that in here. You know, maybe we want this to even start here. And then maybe we'll like pop it up when we actually see our clip, so that those kind of those things match. And
you're just clicking into the audio level and creating those little circles, which we call keyframes. So you can make as many of those as you want inside of a clip. As you see, Stu's already made 4. As he adjusts the levels of the clip. Really easy to remove also. So if you make too many, you can double click the keyframe and it will disappear.
Totally, yeah. So if, like Ryan just said, if I click, it creates a keyframe. If I double click, it removes it. And then let's see, what else would we want? Maybe we'd want like some wind in there. That's a little intense.
blustery.
Okay, yeah, this could be good. Let's try this. And then again, I'm just moving my playhead over here, and this clip is selected. I'm clicking S on my keyboard. Picked that trick up at ISTE, but
will you minimize the preview window so we can see your stacked tracks a little bit clearer?
Yeah.
Cool.
There you go. So yeah. So then again, I'll turn on show. Since I added a new clip, it needs me to click show audio again to reveal that line. Mm-hmm. And again, I'll just use that to adjust the volume. Maybe we'll have this one fade in as well. And it's kind of a loud clip. We don't really want the wind like interfering with the birds. So we'll keep it kind of low throughout. So just getting this down to match the volume there, 14%. And then we can have this one fade out as well. And then let's see how that sounds. We're going to kind of, we'll just preview from the beginning. The music's going to fade out, and then we should have the birds and the wind kind of coming in.
It's a great transition.
Okay, and then here we could maybe add some sounds of the elephants, or, you know, obviously, like, the elephants are living in the plains, so we would have switched that forest, the rainforest clip out, and done something different. But the main point is just how you can kind of build your scenes by matching the types of sound that you're going to find in that scene, layering multiple sounds, and then using the show audio tool to balance the volume of those sounds so that it sort of feels like a natural scene. You know, the wind's not louder than it would be if this was recorded live, and that sounds aren't drowning each other out too.
Yep.
And then we did have our voice recording previously, so I'll actually just bring that back down and just
show you. Should be added already to the timeline.
I deleted it, but it's here. It's here in the project bin.
Gotcha.
So. Let's see. I think this is probably about where I started talking about elephants. But another thing you can do is once your voice recording comes in, you don't want the sounds, whether that's music or sound effects, to drown out your voice. Yep. So another thing you can do is just use those keyframes to dip this volume down while you're talking.
Yeah, to put it underneath your voice recording.
Yep. And then when your voice recording ends, you can bring it back up to kind of keep it engaging.
Nice.
Keep the scene engaging. Yeah. So
let's hear a little sample of that.
Okay. I don't know if we're exactly in the right place, but let's check it out.
That's okay.
When this changes. Okay. So I'm noticing the wind is still a little bit too high, so I'll just dip that down as well.
Oh, I see. If you back your voice recording up just a little bit, I think you'll be kind of relatively on the same.
When this changes, so I could just read that, right? Okay, there we go. Let me get rid of this. Okay, so this should be right. Let's try this. Elephants are herbivores that primarily eat grass and leaves of trees. Okay.
So you're pairing these little flourishes of creativity. Like, you're creating a soundscape, you're adding sounds, which make the piece more engaging because it's adding different modes in which the audience is going to be consuming. But you're pairing that with content knowledge. So students are, on the one hand, being provided an opportunity to be creative, making that intro sequence, using the chroma key, creating the soundscape from layering sounds. And then, you know, you're really allowing them to then make those intentional decisions about how they're communicating the information about their animal by doing exactly what you said. Hey, let's swap out that clip of the rainforest, because maybe African elephants, if that's the animal we're studying, they don't live in rainforests. They live on the savannah. They live in plains. So let's find sounds that represent, like, maybe the plains, or images that are going to represent that habitat, right? And so I think there's creativity in those choices, but there's also some demonstrations of content mastery, because your students have to make those accurate decisions about what facts they're disseminating through this piece.
Absolutely. That's such a great point. Yeah. I mean, it really is bringing the content knowledge to life, right? And through an active process of learning where students are doing that, they're the ones bringing that to life. So they're thinking critically about, okay, what are the kinds of sounds you would hear? What are the sights that you would see? And if they're reading about that, now they're getting to actually like hear that and see that and allow it to sort of come to life for them.
So, yeah, exactly. Yeah. And through the research, right, that you can maybe it not be as engaging if you're putting it together in written form or in other forms in slides. Right. But I like what you said, really bringing it to life, in this video medium.
Yeah. If you'll allow me, my voice recording here was like super quick. I thought I would just re-record it so we can just listen to what this actually might sound like when you're kind of balancing sound, creating a well-paced voice recording, and how important sound actually is to the videos that you create. So
of course,
I'm just going to replace this real quick and redo this voice recording a little more authentically. And we can check it out. Elephants are herbivores. They primarily eat grass and leaves of trees. Okay, so I could record that again since I obviously made a mistake as I was reading, but you can also just like edit those out. Sometimes I like to, when I make a mistake, just keep recording and then go in and edit out. And so I think my mistake is right here. So I'm just going to use the split tool.
But this is a good opportunity to remind ourselves that it doesn't always have to be perfect. And we're in a busy classroom. So if students get approximately what they want to say across in their narration, we're going to be okay with that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah.
Stu has time to be a perfectionist right here.
Totally. Let's see how this sounds and looks. Elephants are herbivores. They primarily eat grass and leaves of trees.
Nice.
Okay. Yeah, a little better there. So that's sort of the editing tips that I wanted to show. And so once students are done with their video, they can turn it in. And as the teacher, when you are when you're teaching this project, excuse me, you can just click review progress and you'll see your students' media here once it's turned in. You can review the videos. And also you'll see student media that's in progress and you can actually open up the editor, see what they're working on, and even leave comments in the editor. So lots of great tools for managing media projects.
Yeah, absolutely. This is a great activity. Again, as October is approaching, we're going to be into October next week. Our next episode will be on October 1st. So again, October is, it's a lot of things, but one thing it is the World Animal Awareness Month. And this is a great time to do something creative, something that can get students excited. This might be, you know, geared maybe more towards the elementary school classroom, but I think as you saw, all of the creative choices that can be made, you can scale this to older students as well. If you're doing this as a one-off creative project about animals specifically, if you're building it into a longer form unit on animal reports, October is a great time to research and celebrate animals and engage in creativity at the same time.
Absolutely.
Well, we hope you enjoyed this episode. And if you did, please give us a like. Let us know how we're doing. You can leave a comment, something you might have liked that you saw on the show or something that you'd like to see. We're always looking for ways to bring new ideas to our shows to help you in your journey as media creators, you and your students' journeys as media creators. So please give us a like. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click that notification bell so you get notified when a new show drops every Tuesday. We're going to be rolling out these quick tips with WeVideo episodes. Make us part of your day. Make us a routine in the morning, after school, when you get home, something to do as a relaxing part of your day. Join us here each and every Tuesday by subscribing and clicking that notification bell. thank you so much for tuning in today. We, like I said, October is coming up. We are going to have a new creative challenge in October. Our creative challenge for September is still open. So head over to WeVideo.com/creative-challenges. If you do submit and you want to share your work on social media with us, please tag us at WeVideo and use the hashtag WeVideoCreative. And we choose a winner every month that we celebrate on social media and send you and your classroom some sweet swag. So go check out that September challenge. And next week's show is going to be all about our October challenge. So please stay tuned for that. Use the whole month of October to celebrate animals, to complete a creative challenge, and to engage in some spooky activities, which we'll be getting to later in the month. But thank you so much for making us a part of your day. Thank you so much for being with us here. Many different ways to engage with WeVideo. If you need support, with anything tutorial, head over to WeVideo.com/academy. There's plenty of tutorial videos that'll help you with the nuts and bolts of the product and get you going right away. Stu, any parting words for today's show?
I think you did a great job. I think you covered it. I think we're in good shape. But I'd love to see what people create. So please do share stuff to social media and tag us so we can check it out. It's always exciting to see what people do with this.
Yeah, absolutely. Hashtag WeVideoCreative at WeVideo. Doesn't have to just be for the creative challenges. Shout us out when you feel like you've got a meaningful piece of content that you want the world to see, and we will help you share it and get the world to see it. And until, thank you, Stu, so much again. We will see you right back here again next Tuesday. But until then, happy creating, everybody. Bye for now.
Take care.